This episode of The Couch is proudly supported by Crown and Andrew's Board Games. Fun for the whole family. And Scoot Airlines. Get out of here with Scoot.
Hello, Australia. Welcome to episode 616 of The Couch. With all our crew, we're ready to go. On the show today, Demelz is coming in to talk music. We've got Faraday's Cage performing for us. They're a wonderful duo based here in WA. They've won Whammy Awards and more. They've got a couple of songs that they've written, and we're going to hear them sing it very soon. We've also got a chance for one lucky home viewer in Griffith in New South Wales to win a trip for two to Singapore, flying Scoot, so stay tuned for that one. Talking tech with Ben Aylett. We've also got the people in from the Bowel Cancer Awareness Group, and they're coming in to talk about Bowel Cancer Awareness Month, so stay tuned for that. Red Cross are coming in to talk about donating blood, which is great, and with Coloured Spaghetti in as well. And later on, we'll do some cooking, talking about spaghetti, but we're not eating spaghetti. We're going to cook up some appetizers with the lovely man, Daniele Cazzolo Forte. I think I got that right, or is that Forte Cazzolo? Forte Cazzolo. There you go. But we'll talk to him later on. Big Couch, stick around. 6:16 starts now.
It's showtime on the couch. It's showtime on the couch. You can see it from your house. You can see it from your house. It's showtime on the couch.
Oh, we've got Travis on camera three making me look beautiful. He doesn't have to do much work, actually. The camera does it all, and I'm natural. But someone that is natural is someone that wrote this song. They're called Faraday's Cage. It's a beautiful song. Please welcome the two kids. They're only 14 years old, singing their own song called Made of Failure, Center Stage.
And when the worlds collide, that's when I start to say to you, I'll keep my head up high and keep my fist at my side. I have to let it out, let it out, let it out, and let it die tonight. I keep on changing my path until the hardship meets an end. Yeah, no one ever asks if what they say I comprehend. I'm losing my mind, I'll gain it in time. I'm scared of letting you down, because I'm made of failure. And when the worlds collide, that's when I start to say to you, keep my head up high and keep my fist at my side. I have to let it out, let it out, let it out tonight.
West Australian, 14 years old, Whammy winners, and they are Faraday's Cage. They'll be back at the end of the show to perform another song. Someone that never performs songs on this show, unfortunately. I'd love her doing ABBA if she could, but I don't want to rub that in. Demelza Leonard's back talking music.
Hello.
Welcome back. I love that top, can I say?
Oh, do
the
you
colour.
Like it? I thought I'd go a
little. It's a shame it doesn't stretch.
No.
So I could use it everywhere. It's actually a nice colour. Is it peach or apricot? What do they call it?
Oh, I'm going to say apricot.
Apricot.
I could be wrong.
It's very nice.
But yeah, I liked it.
Welcome back.
Thank you.
What are we talking about today? You've got some interesting topics.
Very
in music.
Interesting in the world of music this last week. So Frances Bean Cobain is the daughter of Courtney Love and Kurt Cobain. She got married a couple of years ago, fallen out with her husband, Isaiah Silver. Now, he is suing Courtney Love, allegedly for conspiring to kidnap and break into his house and steal the MTV Unplugged guitar that Kurt Cobain performed on the iconic.
What would she want it Kurt. For? Just a...
Well, it's Kurt Cobain's,
yeah.
But so with Frances Bean Cobain and now Isaiah Silver splitting, the court actually awarded that guitar to Isaiah Silver.
Which is her ex,
which means it's now out of the Cobain family.
Yep.
I mean, about a girl. This, Cobain sadly died 5 months after this recording. So they've, according to the legal documents, he has basically said that they've conspired, and it's not just Courtney Love, there's four other people, and one of those is Ross Butler, who
is
currently...
So this is serious?
This
the police
is
are
serious,
involved, and people are going to get charged?
It seems to be more of a civil suit at the moment, but it could go anywhere. Courtney Love has not responded to the allegations at the moment, neither has Ross Butler, who's also been named. Now, Ross is starring in 13 Reasons Why on Netflix at the moment. So it's all very
interesting, can we say. Over a guitar and over money, as usual.
Over guitar, over money, and, something as iconic as Kurt Cobain's guitar from an MTV Unplugged is, quite
serious. Well, obviously, Courtney's got love for that guitar.
Lots of love.
Yes, lots of love.
I see what you did there.
Sorry about it. I'll keep rubbing my microphone.
Now, someone else who might have some love, but we're not a little bit sure at the moment because we think they might be trolling fans, is Eminem and Nicki Minaj.
Who?
Eminem and Nicki Minaj. Two
I thought
rappers.
I heard you right. They're like opposites.
So the rumour mill is basically on overdrive. Nicki and Eminem have performed together on a couple of songs. She has just recently released a brand new song off her upcoming album, which states, "The real Slim Shady, I bagged an M." Now, she also used that as a caption on her Instagram, and fans went nuts over it and basically asked her, "Are you dating Eminem?" And she just responded, "Yes."
So it's all true.
Well, no, there's more to this story. He pops on and starts saying, "Boo, I thought we were going to tell them once we got married." She said, "Oh, well, we had to give something to the fans. I'll see you at home." Turns out she told TMZ that it was all a big joke between the two of them. So kind of put it to rest
everybody
at that time.
Them.
Well, at that time. But then TMZ, also a couple of days later, there was concert video of Eminem performing in Chicago, asking the fans, would you like to see me and Nicki Minaj as an item? The fans said yes.
So they're now an item.
Well, no, he's told Nicki to text him and they'll chat about it.
I would have thought it'd be more sex.
Well, I would have said maybe a booty call or something like that. But, you know.
Has he started behaving now? Because I haven't seen a lot about Eminem.
He's been a little bit reserved and quiet and working on music at the moment. And just kind of out of the spotlight. He did have a song last year with Ed Sheeran. So he has released new music.
Because wasn't he supposed to come to Australia, but they banned him or something like that? There was a controversy.
Yeah, there's been a few things because I think at the time he had the chainsaw and they said you couldn't perform this song and, you know, censorship and all that sort of thing.
Well, good luck to them.
Yeah, so we'll have to keep you posted on that lovely situation.
I can't wait. I think this is going to be a big development in the news.
Well, I would predict if they are together, the MTV Video Music Awards will be where they will
definitely
make their appearance.
Definitely. And I can just see the baby next. Is she pregnant?
Well,
Eminem's child.
Now, All Saints. Do you remember All Saints? Back in the late 90s, early 2000s.
They
girl
were one
group.
Of those manufactured groups, weren't they?
They were. And they came into the pop market just on the back of the success of the Spice Girls as well. So the four girls, the Appleton sisters, Shaznae Lewis and Nicki as well. So
they sang pretty well. I love their
music. They had great music. They were kind of more that sexier, edgy vibe to the Spice Girls, whereas the Spice Girls was that cheesy pop. They've teamed up. Now, they've actually released five studio albums.
Are you serious?
Five studio albums.
What would they be, in their 50s now or maybe not? 40s?
Maybe 40s now. Okay. They're only a few years older than me. Not quite there yet. So.
I remember the song we just played there.
So Pure Shores was produced by William Orbit, who is a well-known producer and also had his own success in 1999 with the trance song Barber's Adagio for Strings. So he has teamed up with them again after 18 years and will be working with them on their upcoming album Testament, which is due out July
13. How many albums did you say they've...
They've had five. So they reunited about four or 5 years ago and they've had three albums since then. So
see, now I thought they disappeared and yet they've released five
albums. They've been creating music, but with All Music, it hasn't really taken to the
charts. Good to see them form with a couple of others, like I was saying, Atomic Kitten and a few others, maybe do a concert together.
Well, that's where a lot of those 90s and early 2000 artists seem to be
going.
Well,
I seem to see them here in Perth at the Astor Theatre. They all turn up, Hot Chocolate and all those people.
They're
great musicians.
And it's great to kind of have that trip down memory lane as well. ABBA, well, there you go.
Look, I was disappointed about ABBA. I have to say to you, they've already recorded those two songs last June.
Yeah.
It's coming out this year, at the end of the year. NBC are releasing the clip, but it's not them. It's what they're calling avatars, which is the fake CGI.
Yeah, but it's them recording the music for the virtual tour.
And I watched the interview, Demelza, and Benny from ABBA said they were amazed. They walked into the studio as if they never stopped singing. They loved it. He said it went too quick, because they were so professional that they just sang the two songs over and done with, and they all loved it, which was amazing.
Well, I predict potentially a UK number one for Christmas for them. I think that's why it's been released where it is. So.
And I reckon let's hold that space, because if they do really well, I wouldn't be surprised they release a couple of songs a year.
Quite possibly. I mean, that's how the music cookie crumbles, really.
Anything else for us today?
Let's have a look at the top three.
Oh, good thinking. Let's have a look on the screen at top three.
Coming in at number three, it's Childish Gambino, aka Donald Glover, with This Is America.
Wax.
Post Malone with Better Now at number two. And at number one, Five Sauce with Youngblood.
Why does that sound like an old song that used to be around years ago? If you want me, come and get me.
Oh, yes.
You won't have a chance if you don't move now.
I want to say Little River
John
Favon.
Yeah, Little River Band.
Yes.
There you go. We're on the same page.
Excellent.
Thank you, Demelza. Off to look after your little boy.
Yes, little one.
And can I ask you, where can we catch you online with your radio
online,
station?
Online, Boss Mode Radio. So www.bossmoderadio.com.au, 24/7, business and beats all day.
Beautiful. There you go. Thank you, Demelza. We'll see you in a couple of weeks.
Yes.
That is Demelza Lennard talking music, always fun. We'll be back after the break when we talk to Ben Aylett, that technical stuff. See you then. Welcome back to the couch. It's time to talk technology with the man who knows everything there is to know about every single computer, technology, security, cyber, all that sort of stuff. Ben Aylett, thank you for coming in.
G'day, Fred. Thanks for having me along.
And of course, remember benaylett.com is his website.
That's right.
Thank you. Now, what are we talking about today?
Well, today we're talking about routers. So we'll start off with how things have gone wrong in the last week or so.
Tell us what a router is first, because those people at home go, what's he talking about? Is it a modem?
A router, it's kind of like a modem. So a router is like a gateway that takes a connection from the outside world and then spreads it out through the inside of it. It's got a lot of smarts in it. So it's like our firewall, it's our protection. It's also our wireless router as well. So what do we operate
at home on a router? Give us an example. Would you do a printer? What would work on it?
Everything connects to your router. And the router is also responsible for handing out addresses inside your network, so the computers know where they are. So if I want to have my computer talk to my printer, it's the router that decides who gets what address. And then when I say I want to print something, the router says, no worries, I know where that printer is, and it sends the packets.
So it's pretty important to everybody who's got Wi-Fi at home or internet.
Any sort of internet. So if you want to connect, any home or business, if you want a connection to the internet, or if you want to have a network that's inside your home or business that's managed properly, a router is pretty much essential. I don't think you'll see any business without a router.
Now, there's been some news lately about some things that have gone wrong with routers as well, haven't they?
That's right, and I've covered this on my website at benaylett.com. 500,000 routers have been compromised, we suspect, by the Russians.
Yep.
And these 500,000 routers were poised to disrupt a major event in the Ukraine. I think it was the UEFA Champions League. Mm. They were going to try and disrupt the broadcast services.
Bringing it down using other people's routers? They hack into it, basically.
Exactly. So these 500,000 routers were going to be used as a weapon against the Ukraine. This is all speculation at the moment, but it's been that much of a big impact and that much of a worry because the sort of malware that's been installed on these routers to compromise them is incredibly complex. And it's very, very powerful. So
should people worry if they've got these routers at home?
They should be concerned. They should be paying attention. Sorry. And it's actually such a threat that the FBI themselves have actually stepped in to take over this network and then effectively shut it down. So
do we have a list of them?
Because I do.
You were saying to me there's a few.
Yeah, I've just pulled up the list here. So if you've got a router by Linksys, MikroTik, Netgear, if you've got a network attached storage device by QNAP, or if you've got a TP-Link router, you really should be checking with your manufacturer for the latest updates. Mm. If that's too scary, if you've had those routers for a long time, it might be time to upgrade to a new router.
And I would say please check your routers because TP-Link's one that I've heard a lot of, and Netgear as well.
Yeah, so yep. And Linksys. Linksys have been legendary because they used to be owned by Cisco. And they've been legendary for the sort of quality that they present.
Is there something on the market that can replace these old routers that does a better job?
Oh, there's heaps of routers, and one of them is the Asus RT-AC88U. This, I've just done a bit of a review on it. Thank you very much to Asus for letting me play with this. It is a beast, this thing. It is a gaming router, and it is ultra-fast. It's loaded with lots and lots of features. They retail around about the $420 mark, and they do have a couple of things over the top of other routers in that price class. They integrate with a service called If This Then That, which is a really cool... If This Then That.
Simple.
It's a program, it's a Internet of Things or some sort of a Smart Things websites where you can generate your own rules and they'll do things based on what you do. So, for example, you can control your Wi-Fi access with your voice. If you've got an Amazon Alexa, using the If This Then That service, you can say, Alexa, turn off the Wi-Fi. Or you can say, turn off the Wi-Fi. Tell the router to shut down the Wi-Fi. If it's dinner time, you can just tell the router to shut off the Wi-Fi and all the kids will come out of the rooms.
Screaming, saying, who's turned off the internet?
Exactly. Yeah.
And you'd say, oh, it's dinner time.
That's right.
What a great idea.
Yeah, you don't have to yell.
Did you say they're only $449?
They're $420.
Oh, $420. $420.
Super fast, aimed at gaming as well. And the thing that really impressed me when I got this out of the box, if you have a look at the back there, you'll notice all these ports along the back.
There's a lot of them. Let's have a look on screen. I think we've got it there now.
Yep. So this is...
Why do we need so many?
This is the centre of your network. So if you've got things like an Apple TV or a Roku box or a smart TV or anything else that you want to have plugged directly into the router, this will go right in the middle of your home. and it'll spread out the wireless thing.
And that's why you've got all the aerials, I'm assuming. Yeah. The range is quite good.
The range is great. Mm. Range is really, really good. They also include some other really nice features. So you've got a smartphone app for it. It's also got what's called AI protection. So it's using artificial intelligence to watch for any attacks that might happen. So it's got a next generation firewall. Really cool. And the antennas, it does something called beam forming. So using the antennas, they can almost direct the wireless signal to where it needs to go.
Oh, wow.
So you can get up to 500 square meters of Wi-Fi coverage.
That's good.
That's amazing.
And where can we get one of these from?
You can get them at most major retailers. I have seen them at Harvey Norman. I've also seen them at PLE Computers.
And they're local people as well. Harvey Norman everywhere around Australia.
Exactly,
as well.
Yes. Anywhere in Australia, you should be able to find it. Or you can go directly to the ASUS website.
Quick question for you. People have asked me, what do they do with their home phones now that the NBN's in? Does it automatically switch over or does it turn off?
The old home phone service as we know it is being switched off. So if you've got an old rotary dialer, it might be time to turf it. Or hang on.
So say you've got a Telstra phone,
yeah,
but your internet's with, say, TPG. Do you need to tell somebody or will your phone automatically disconnect?
You do have to work this out with your you do have to work this out with your internet service provider. Because they're responsible for making sure it works before and after.
And how are we going with the internet? NBN, has that pretty much reached everybody yet or not? Because I know I've got it in my house now.
Yeah. NBN rollout at the moment, I think off the top of my head, we're talking about 60% of the way through. Mm-hmm. So we may be on track to completion by 2020, which is the goal.
Yep.
As far as speed goes, there's been a bit of a hiccup. With the fixed wireless, they've stopped promising up to 100 megabits per second. They're saying 50 megabits per second is all we're going to have.
And that's still pretty good.
It's still good, but it's not what we were promised from day one.
What were you saying you get at home? About 98 or something?
I get 98, yes.
That's pretty good, isn't it?
It's amazing.
Do you notice the difference? Because I know even on 50, I notice my difference. I get and download Foxtel movies very quickly. Mm-hmm. I can upload the show to Foxtel very quickly.
Yeah.
So the speed is just an amazing thing. And it's just so smooth and easy to use now.
It is. It's really fast. I notice the difference when it comes to uploading and downloading large files.
Yep.
When it comes to streaming, I've got a family of five. And they're all streaming YouTube or music or Netflix or whatever. And it all happens and we don't get buffering.
Where can we find out more about Ben Aylett?
Well, you just go to benaylett.com. Simple as that.
You've got your own website. There it is on screen. Benaylett.com. Very easy. How can you help people?
Well, just get in touch at benaylett.com. You can give me a call on 041-996-5196. And every Monday night on 6 PR from 8:20 PM to 9 PM.
Sounds fantastic. Thank you very much, Ben. We'll see you in a couple of weeks. Now it's time to put a smile on someone's face. We are ringing Sylvia Lando. Now, she's in Griffiths in New South Wales. We're going to give her a quick call because she's our Pick Up the Phone contestant, thanks to Scoot. We're going to give her the chance. If she picks up the phone, she's going to win two tickets flying Scoot Airlines to Singapore. Let's dive. Call that number, please, Ben. We'll give her five rings to answer. And, of course, don't forget, you can enter the competition as well. We'll give you details after this. Let's dial her. Let's see if we can hear Sylvia Lando pick up the phone. There we go. We're dialing her now, thanks to Scoot. We hope she answers the phone within five rings. That's three. That's four. That's five. Bad luck, Sylvia. If you're watching the show, you've missed out. You must answer the phone. If you don't answer the phone, you don't win. And that's the end of that. Now, if you would like to be part of Scoot's Pick Up the Phone, you can win tickets to Singapore or anywhere else where Scoot flies in the network. All you've got to do is send the code word, which is Scoot. It's on your screen right now, with your name and your address to 0439 929 99. You can SMS it to us. Or, as you can see on screen right now, you can email it to, for those people who don't use text, scoot@thecouch.com.au. That's scoot@thecouch.com.au. It's open to anybody in Australia. You can enter the competition and we'd love to give away another one. Now, next week we'll do it again and hopefully we'll have another home viewer. We might even go to Adelaide next week. We've got heaps of callers in Adelaide and also Victoria. So bad luck to our Griffith person there. Sylvia, you missed out, but hopefully next week we'll give it away. Time now to talk about bowel cancer. It's the awareness month. It's June. So we're going to be talking to the director of Bowel Cancer Australia very soon. And Nisha will be talking to him. But first, check out their commercial.
So when it comes to keeping people alive, who gets all the credit? The heart. Pump, 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 pump. What else does it do? Nothing. I tell you what I do. I take the trash out every day, sometimes twice. And what's the cherry on top of that crap sundae that's my life? I'm the home of Australia's second deadliest cancer. Aren't I? Hello? No. No one's even listening.
We're very pleased to be joined now on the show by Associate Professor Dr. Graham Newstead. Now, Dr. Newstead is the chairman of the International Council of Coloproctology. However, today he's talking to us in the capacity as Director of Bowel Cancer Australia and on their board, the serving clinician as well. So welcome to the show. Great to have you, Graham.
Thank you very much. Nice to be there with you.
Wonderful. Now, it's Bowel Cancer Month. We're Awareness Month this month in June. How important is it for us to increase awareness?
Well, you've just shown a commercial which shows that we need to be taking a lot more care about what comes out the other end of our gastrointestinal tract, of our bowel. And bowel cancer is Australia's second deadliest cancer. And more than 10 people a day die from it around Australia. Ridiculously, it is a preventable cancer. And unlike the two most common cancers in men and women, which are breast and prostate, if you're a non-smoker, neither of those are preventable, hopefully findable early. Whereas bowel cancer is actually preventable, and so it's ridiculous that some 4,500 people are dying every year and some 15,000 people have it, and we can pretty much get close to eliminating it if we do the right thing.
Absolutely. And Graham, in terms of increasing awareness, it's about being proactive, isn't it, in terms of having those regular checks. Tell us a bit about how people can be more proactive.
Well, the national, our federal government has worked with organisations such as ours, Bowel Cancer Australia, over many, many years to finally get to come to fruition a national bowel cancer screening program. And if you are on the Medicare register, as the vast majority of people are in Australia, you will automatically be sent a test kit in the mail when you turn 50, and currently every 5 years thereafter. Now, that test kit is returned by under 40% of Australians. And the reason is, of course, that people don't want to have anything to do with their bowels and their bowel motions. Mm. It's a pretty yucky topic. And all that it requires is when the kit arrives, open it, take the brush that's in it, wipe it in the toilet water before you flush, put the little paint onto the two little test strips, the material from the toilet water, seal it and post it off in the mail. You do that with a couple of bowel motions over 2 days, and then you'll get a result. Now, what that test looks for is blood. It's not looking for cancer nor polyps, which are the warty growths that are the forerunners of bowel cancer, but it's looking for blood. Now, a lot of people will have a positive blood test simply because they're getting a little spotting of blood from something else like hemorrhoids, and a lot of women that have had babies will know that they've got what they call lumps in the bottom or hemorrhoids or piles, and they're very common, and you can get a bit of bleeding from those. And so do men get it, who are straining hard and their bowel motions are a bit firm. And that's very common. We're all actually born with hemorrhoids and they're normal. And it's only when they get a bit bigger that they cause trouble. So the good news is that a lot of those positive tests are going to be due to hemorrhoids. But if it's not, at least then you're going to get your colonoscopy, which is what you need to have done when you've got a positive test, and that's a telescope around the bowel. And with that telescope, you can see what, if anything other than hemorrhoids, is causing the trouble.
It's important, Graham, what I'm hearing there is that you can make a more informed and educated decision with a relatively quick process. So just maybe, you know, 5 minutes per day and shooting it into the post box.
Absolutely. The government recognised the importance of this, and consequently they are in the process of increasing the screening interval from 5 yearly to 2 yearly.
Wonderful.
And if you take, that'll happen by 2020, which is just around the corner. And if you take people who have done the test and sent it back and who have a positive and who are found on colonoscopy, the second essential part of testing and screening, is that a lot of those who do have either a very large polyp or a very early cancer are cured then. And if you look at the people who present late with bowel cancer compared to people who are found on the screening test, the incidence of cure is so much greater if you are found to have been tested by colonoscopy when you've got a positive FIT, fecal immunological test.
That's really important to know, Graham. I guess in terms of signs and symptoms, we don't want to wait till symptoms, but what are some of those signs and symptoms that people
right.
can watch out
well,
for?
When I was a medical student, we were taught that the sign of or the symptoms of cancer of the bowel was a blockage causing obstruction in your bowel or blood in the toilet. Well, by the time you're seeing that as overt bleeding or getting crampy pain, you may have a much more advanced cancer because the diameter of the bowel is then being blocked or partially blocked by a growing cancer, and it may have already then invaded through the wall of the bowel. And you've got the risk of spread then, and you may miss the boat.
Yeah. So early intervention and being proactive. Just quickly, because I could talk about, I think it's a very important topic, but just as a final question for you, Graham, what can people do to reduce their risk, and where can they find some information to learn
right.
more?
Right. Well, lifestyle is terribly important. So all the normal important things like eating a balanced diet, getting fiber in your diet, avoiding obesity, taking exercise, and terribly important that they take note of the test kit when it's sent to them and do it. Don't throw it in the bin because you may be throwing your life away. Further information can be found on the website of Bowel Cancer Australia, which is basically Bowel Cancer Australia, one word, bowelcanceraustralia.org.
Wonderful. Graham, thank you so much for joining us. We hope to have you on the couch again. Really meaningful and important information you've provided our audience with today.
Thank you so much for having me.
Pleasure. Thank you, Graham. Now, if you've missed any of that at all, you can, of course, go to thecouch.com.au, our Facebook page, and you'll be able to find more information there. Back to you, Fred.
Thank you, Nisha. And can I say, well done, Graham, because I actually turned 50 last year and I did get one of those
Good.
Kits.
Excellent.
And can I say, it wasn't that much of a work to send it back. And it came back about 2 weeks later telling me I'm all clear. So, well done. Get on board. Check out the website, Nisha said. And we'll see you at the other side of this break for more. We're going to talk about the Red Cross next. You're watching The Couch. Welcome back to The Couch. Time for us to talk about the Red Cross and the amazing work they're doing. They need plasma to be donated. To talk to our special guest today, Nisha Seth.
Thank you, Fred. We have Dave Favory from the Australian Red Cross Blood Service joining us. Welcome.
Thanks for having me.
Absolute pleasure. Now, Dave, you have an exciting job at
yes.
the service. So you are the Corporate and Community Officer, is that right?
That's correct. So I work with getting organisations and people involved in blood donation and getting them to come in as a group or individually to help us sustain the blood supply for Australia, for WA especially.
Wonderful. And I think a lot of our audience will know how critical it is in not only accidents, but in actual surgery and in many situations for people to have access to blood.
That's right. So there's a lot of different things that we can use blood for, blood and plasma. Mm-hmm. So we are looking to guide people towards plasma donations, which is mm-hmm. a very important part of the hospital supply. Mm-hmm. So plasma, we can create 18 different life-saving products mm-hmm. to help people. So we are encouraging people to come in mm-hmm. and come in and donate plasma and help us sustain the supply.
Fantastic. So when you donate plasma, tell us about the process. Does it differ much from donating blood, or is it quite similar?
It is a very similar process. You're still in the chair with the needle in your arm mm-hmm. and we can extract the plasma from the blood. We then keep your plasma, return the whole blood to you, and we can use that plasma to create the products that we need to save people and give them a better quality of life.
Wonderful. Now, it's a relatively easy process too. You can go in your lunch break perhaps or after work. Tell us about
that. That's correct. So you can come in anytime, Monday to Friday. We also open Sundays in some donor centres. You can jump on our website, donateblood.com.au, or call 13 14 95. We can help you out, book an appointment for you, run you through your eligibility requirements and get you involved in blood donations.
Fantastic. Now, some larger corporates do support you, being corporate being one of your key focuses in your role. Tell us about how they can get involved.
So the corporates can get involved by supporting their staff members and employees to come in and donate blood. So we are looking for 5,000 donors to come in and donate plasma every month. This is where the corporates can come on board. They've got larger numbers. Small or large can come through. They can jump in and become a part of our program, our Red 25 program. Donate blood and plasma and help save lives. They can jump on the website again, donateblood.com.au, and register as a group and come in and donate some plasma.
Fantastic. And being a psychologist, as the audience knows, really important for your citizenship behaviour for organisations.
Yes.
So I'm sure that you see people coming in and how meaningful it is for them once they've donated.
Very
well.
Much so. Yeah. People love the feeling of giving blood, giving back to the community and actually helping to save lives.
Wonderful. Now, there is some criteria. Can people find out more on your website?
They can jump on the website and have a look. We've got a list of criteria there for eligibility. This will help them make their decision, give them a yes or no on if they can or can't donate blood.
Fantastic. Now, there's one more special day this month. When and what is that?
There is. So June the 14th, we have World Blood Donor Day. So it's a day that we use to help raise awareness around blood donation and encourage people to come in and donate blood and plasma. They can jump on the website again, donateblood.com.au, and have a look on there and fill out their criteria and actually come in and help us save some lives.
Fantastic. Well, Dave, thank you so much for joining us. But just before we go, maybe if you look down the barrel of the camera there and let everyone know where to go to find out more.
So you can call 13 14 95 to make an appointment or jump on donateblood.com.au and come in and donate plasma.
Fantastic. Very well done. Thank you so much. So there you have it. It's nice, relatively easy to go in your lunch break, look at the website, have a look at some of the different locations around Perth. Of course, if you've missed anything, as usual, you can go to our Facebook page, The Couch. But other than that, it's back to you, Fred.
Thank you very much. And Dave, can I just ask you a quick question before you leave us?
Yes.
Do you still get those little, like, chocolates and nibblies?
There is a lot there. We've got chocolates, we've got biscuits, we've got sausage rolls and pies.
Not that should be the only reason you go there, but all my friends, if you know what I mean.
No, not at all.
Good place to have a cup of tea and
maybe... We can go back to work then feeling nourished. Right?
There you
can
go.
Come back to work feeling nourished and full and
you feel
happy,
good.
Happy with yourself.
Very important.
Well done. Keep up the great work and we'll have the Red Cross back on the show very soon. Thank you, Nisha, as well.
Thanks,
time to talk about more about inclusion and disability and how people can be treated more with respect is our very own Michelle Varley, and she's got another fantastic segment called Coloured Spaghetti. Over to you.
Thanks, Fred. Welcome to Coloured Spaghetti. We've got a great show for you today. We're going to do some artwork and I've got some really good friends here today. So let's first of all meet them. Who have we got here?
Me, Ben.
You're Ben. How old are you, Ben?
14.
14. Can you tell me something about yourself? What do you like doing?
I like watching Flushed Away and then watching Tooth Fairy and then I love getting my hair cut and then I quite like watching music videos on the telly.
So you love your
and
movies?
And I like making curry for dinner.
Do you actually
make... I'm making my own foods for dinner.
Do you make curry yourself?
I can do it myself.
Fantastic. And do you like eating it?
I do.
Oh, great.
And I quite like cooking lots of foods on my own.
Well, that's awesome that you know how to cook. Okay, who have we got here?
Hi, my name is Patsy Wadman.
And how old are you, Patsy?
16.
What do you like doing, Patsy?
In Charlotte. A hat word of Fight
a Kaya. Yeah? Well, you like watching Twilight. Is that one of your favourite movies?
Yeah.
Fantastic. Who have we got here?
Ben.
Brilliant. It's good to see you back here, Brilliant. How old are you?
Cal.
12. And what do you like doing at the weekends?
Fortnite.
And
soccer.
That's a computer game, isn't it? And playing soccer.
Yes.
Awesome. Well, we're very glad to have you here. And we've got a new visitor today. What's your name?
Hi, I'm Caroline and I'm 12 years old.
Caroline, thank you for coming to Coloured Spaghetti. What kind of things do you like doing at the weekend?
I like watching YouTube and I like doing drama and acting and dancing.
Oh, okay, fantastic. Thank you for coming along today. We've also got two help us. We've got Kai and we've got Lily here to help us to do this art activity. Now, sometimes people say to me, I'm no good at art, I can't do art, I'm rubbish at art. And they saw from the lights, yeah, it's a bit bright and hot, but that's okay, it'll be all right. And you know, I don't think that anyone is bad at art. I think everybody does great art because every piece of art is different. And we love things that are different. Hey, Patsy, can you tell me, how are you different from Ben?
Ben with short eyes. He's holding my hands. Oh,
he's holding your hands. Yeah. He's a good friend of yours, isn't he? Oh, that's lovely. Yeah, like you said, Patsy, he's got short hair and you've got long hair. Caroline, how are you different to Kai?
Kai's taller than me. He's also older than me. He wears glasses and I don't.
He does. Brilliant. How are you and me different? How are we different? Look at our hands. We've got different coloured skin. Actually, everybody put their hands in. I want to see everyone's hands. We've all got different coloured skin, haven't we? And how beautiful are we all?
Great.
So we are great, and that's because we're all different. So let's do some art and let's all make it as different as we possibly can. Use shaving foam. Okay, I'm gonna spray this shaving foam down here.
What about me?
For you. And
oh, nice.
For you. And for you.
What's it for? What's
and
the shaving
for
foam for?
You, we're gonna make a picture, a beautiful picture. Okay, all right, so if my helpers, can you help just straighten it off a little, flatten it down?
Can I flatten it?
Yeah, flatten it down there, that's it, awesome. So we'll keep it all together and hang on a minute, Ben, give me yours and we'll just scrape it there. Okay, all right, now we're gonna get the colors. What colors have we got here?
Blue.
I
want blue, please, I want blue.
Yellow.
Red. Green.
And green.
I want the blue one.
We've nearly finished. Let's do this art activity and I think you'll love it so much that your eyes will be better.
You'll be
all right. Now, if we give you each a colour.
Nice to say, wasn't it?
Yeah.
I want blue, please.
Okay, you have blue. I'll take you blue there. Red, you want red. Which colour would you like?
Yellow.
Yellow?
What do you do with blue?
That's
what
can
same
you do
as with
your
it? Can I paint
t-shirt?
The foam with it?
No, what you're going to do, I'm going to show you. I want you to pick it up and go tap, tap, tap. Can you do that with your paintbrush?
How much slap it on?
Tap, 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 tap.
That's
tap. Okay, all right, now everybody swap the colours around. So you've all got a different colour. One for you, one for you. Where's your paintbrush gone? Oh, it's over there. Okay, ready, can you do that? Tap, 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 tap. How are you going? Good, looking good. All right, one more time, let's swap the colours around. You've had blue, you can have green, and you can have red and yellow, okay? One more. This does get a bit messy, but you know, it's only shaving foam and it smells really nice. All right, now we're gonna have our stick, and this is what we're gonna do. Twirly, whirly, whirly, woo. So just make some nice big swirls in it. Can you make some swirls?
Like this.
Yep, that's
yeah,
it.
You got it.
You got it, Patsy, can you do some swirls? We're nearly ready. All right, Ben, stop there, because we don't want to mix the colours up too much. Ben, here's your bit of paper. Can you?
One.
Okay, all right, let's get your bit of paper on. And just very gently, push the paper down and lift it off. This is the magic bit.
Oh, wow.
Get our ruler and scrape it off. Wow, look, Patsy, look at your picture. Look, everyone, hold your pictures up. They're so incredible. I love them. And what you can do.
Look at my one.
Look, show it to the cameras. How beautiful are they? what you can do is do a template and make some cards out of them. Lots of things you can do with this. All right, now I just want to make a quick advert to JETS, Joondalup Entertainment Theatre School in Joondalup. They run classes for drama, for singing, and hip hop for all abilities. This year, we've just started a special class for kids with special needs. The website will come up on the screen now. Please visit and come and see us. We'd love to have you along. Guys, you can get your hands in this if you like. Go on, get
messy.
Oh
my God, it feels so nice.
Oh, did you get some on your nose?
Michelle.
Oh, brilliant.
I think you have something on your
nose. I haven't. Yeah. No way. Oh, yeah. Lily. Yeah.
Sorry.
Have you got some? Lily, no. Come here. Oh, did
I put it on me? Can I put it on me?
Thank you so much, guys. Please visit my Facebook page, Colour Spaghetti. We will see you soon. Wave goodbye, everyone.
Bye.
No, Michelle, I reckon this segment's more about you having fun with shaving cream. You should spray it all over her face, kids. No? No? Okay. We're going to take a break. Be back. We're joining the kitchen with Daniele right after this. We're going to do some appetizers. You're watching The Couch. See you then. Welcome back to the kitchen here on Fresh and Local. And Daniele Fottecazzola is back with me. Did I get it right?
Yeah, that was
beautiful.
Good. That
I'm glad I pronounced it right.
Natural right there.
Daniele, for all those people who don't know you, tell us what you do around Perth.
So I do a few things, Fred. So I'm a food blogger, so recipes. I share recipes online. I do a lot
of cooking
courses, workshops. Yeah, I do get invited to a lot of restaurant openings, which is also part of the perks. Yep. And yeah, just in media, journalist
as
well.
You're a journalist
as well. A little bit of everything.
Amazing, and you're an amazing home cook as well.
Yes.
Do we call you a chef? Do you have to be professionally?
Yeah,
to
I feel like you have to be professional. The expectations
are
a lot higher if I say a chef.
But your cooking is
amazing. Cooking with the heart. Cooking with the heart.
And you're Italian.
Yes.
And what part? You're Sicilian.
Sicilian.
So a lot of your cooking is from a Sicilian background, or do you cook all regions?
Yeah, I mean, I'm mostly like familiar with Sicilian cuisine, but obviously, like, I travel to Italy quite regularly, and you know, growing up here as well, our Italian cuisine is kind of shared from cultures from all the regions.
Yes, exactly.
So you know, a bit of a national Italian cuisine.
Fantastic.
What
are we doing today?
So today I thought of doing a really light and simple appetizer, so perfect for your aperitivo.
Well, let me run through. What have we got here?
So what we're doing first, we're making this a long bruschetta to share.
So that's the bread we've got there.
That's the bread, and then we've got three different toppings.
What
have
we got?
So we've got marinated capsicums, we've got some soft goat's cheese, we've got mozzarella bocconcini, little mouthfuls.
And small tomatoes.
We've got some tomatoes which need to be marinated.
Is that ricotta?
Ricotta and...
olive oil?
No. Honey.
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 Oh, you've got the olive oil there, haven't you?
Yeah, the olive
and
oil there.
And this is?
We've got some prosciutto.
Yep.
Which is my favourite cold meat. And
fantastic.
Then some rocket and some arugula, sorry.
When would you recommend this sort of food?
This is perfect. I think, you know, it's cooling
like
down now. Yeah, it's perfect for a starter, you know. Have an aperitivo, an aperitif, so you know, have a spritz or something
spritz,
like that.
Spritz, yes,
yeah,
I know that's your favourite.
That's my favourite.
You never
and
see
I,
you without one of those.
I know, ones. I know. I hear that
that's
a lot. I don't know if I should be worried. So it's perfect for, you know, you're having people over and nibbling and trying different things.
Well, let's put it all together. What are we going to put on there?
Okay,
first?
So the first one I'm going to do is I'm going to concert this tomato one. So this is the traditional bruschetta, which you normally see is tomatoes. They can be diced, they can be sliced.
What does bruschetta mean? Because I say bruschetta, but I know it's bruschetta.
Bruschetta. I just believe it's just the name of the dish.
Isn't bruschetta? What does brusca mean? Doesn't it mean toasted bread or something?
Not that I'm familiar with. But
I made that up.
Yeah.
So I thought you were going to say that's
yeah,
it.
Yeah, that's it. So we got
some salt,
some oil, and some salt.
And you know what? Olive oil is the best, folks. If you're going to use some oil, use the best. Do you use extra virgin or just the normal?
Yeah, extra virgin olive oil. Yeah, that's the best. Now, what I've done with my bread, so I've sliced my bread in half, so the way you can share it on a board is have the two slices.
Yep.
And what I've done is I put it in the oven to 100 degrees just for like a few minutes.
Yep.
Just waited for it to toast a bit, and then I poured some olive oil on the top, got some
color
garlic
toast.
Cloves, and rubbed the
you
garlic
the
over
real,
it.
The fresh garlic on
yeah,
it. Beautiful.
Yeah, so rubbed the fresh garlic.
I'll get you to put it on. I know Sonia's saying we've got a couple of minutes to go, so we'll put that on. It's pretty simple, isn't it? Really?
Yeah, so the way I'm doing it is like dividing it into sections. So we're going
to
have...
Tell me something, do you separate all your stuff before? That way you've got it all ready to go?
Yeah, sometimes it's easy, especially if you're in a hurry and you kind of know, like, you know, you're planning your day. Yeah, it's a good way. Instead of, you know, having everything out and having to constantly wash dishes, I do like to have
it all together. Now, you know what makes me very happy is when I love tomato.
Yeah.
Tomato and bread. When I was a kid, my mum used to use the stale bread.
Yeah.
Put a little bit of water and tomato and a bit of salt and pepper, and I used to eat that as a meal.
Yeah, that's so love that. I have that for breakfast sometimes. It's just so they now I'm putting some bocconcini on there.
I'll let you put everything on. Now, Daniele, while we're still preparing the meal, tell us about your website. If people want more information from you,
so to go and check out dinewithdaniele.com, and Instagram is Dine with Daniele, and Facebook Dine with Daniele. So I'm starting workshops.
You're doing classes.
Yeah, so starting workshops and
classes.
Do you
do parties? Can people book you and you can cook for, say, 20 people for a dinner party?
I haven't done parties just yet, but that could be something.
I'm talking
to
about
look
cooking,
into.
Of course.
Yeah, I can look into that onto the horizon. But if you want a group,
Like if you're going to have a party for 10 or 12 people, I'd invite Daniele to do the cooking, write up the menu.
Yeah.
And maybe, you know, for a couple of $100,000.
I do team workshops, team bonding days. So I've done a few of those.
Do you like doing the group stuff?
Yeah, I think so. It's a great way. It's a great way to get everyone together, and especially
people love cooking, don't they?
Yeah, they do.
Sonia's telling me we have to really hurry it up.
Got to really hurry that up.
We're going to end the show today with Faraday's Cage, folks. The song, Sonia, is called
Fire Inside.
We're going to end with them. But Daniele, this looks beautiful. Yes. Would you like me to try it before we go to the?
Yeah, go for it.
You don't want me to eat the whole.
No. So the way you divide it is you just cut it into different components. Go ahead.
It looks incredible. Thank you for watching, everyone. Thank you, Daniele. I'm going to try that. We'll see you next week on the couch. Daniele will be back in a couple of weeks. Until then, bye-bye for now. Here's Faraday's Cage. Yum.
Wash over the ruined lands. It takes its toll before the feet. Orange haze, silver skies, they're fighting over night and day. Do we become what we despise? With fiery hair of red and eyes of white, brighter than the stars above. Carries no disguise or alibis, nothing left behind or alive but the fire inside. A dying breath, a spark of life. Where do we begin and end? Do we become what we despise? With fiery hair of red and eyes of white, brighter than the stars above. Carries no disguise or alibis, nothing left behind or alive but the fire inside. Disguise or alibis. nothing left behind, or alive but the fire inside.
This episode of The Couch is proudly supported by Crown and Andrews Board Games. Fun for the whole family. And Scoot Airlines. Get out of here with Scoot.